All started in 2014, where all your homies did the ice bucket challenge and watched Ninjago rebooted and played the incredible Skylanders Trap Team video game. As an 8-year-old boy, I was really into all sorts of things like Lego and Star Wars and Marvel and stuff like that. But one day, on the 13th of August, a very special movie released.
You son of a bitch. Hey! Take those headphones off right now!
So my 8-year-old self was like, what the hell is this? This is like a mix between Star Wars and Marvel? What? And oh boy, I loved it so much. These were all already characters in the Marvel universe, but now they actually have a movie. And this is also how I actually got to meet these characters. Thanks to the movie, man. Oh boy, I mean, this movie is written by James Gunn and a lucky occasion, because I already watched some things from him when I was 8, which was the live-action Scooby-Doo movies. Those were absolutely so good, and when I realized that guy made Guardians of the Galaxy, oh my god, I just lost my mind. I mean, you know, those were really two movies that I really watched as a kid that I really adored, because it was live-action Scooby-Doo, oh my god, it was like such perfection. It was literally the perfect Scooby-Doo movie ever made. But surprise, surprise, another actor in this movie was also already one of my favorite actors, because Chris Pratt also played in a Lego movie. And oh my days, this movie I watched so much as a kid, and he was also in Jurassic World, obviously. I remember hiring this movie, I guess, from my local library, because they had, movie releases from certain cinema movies, you know, before anyone else. And I absolutely adored Guardians of the Galaxy. I watched it twice in one day, and you know, I think it's perfect.
Woohoo!
What? No applause?
And another reason why that I love Guardians of the Galaxy much as I do right now is because they released it on Disney Infinity 2.0, which I absolutely loved, because I could play as Star-Lord, Gamora, Drax and Rocket, and I bought these characters too, and I really loved it because you could shoot some insane guns with Rocket, slashing some enemies with Drax's knives, go and use your jet boots with Star-Lord and use Gamora's sword, and you know, it was fantastic, man. I grew really fond of the Guardians of the Galaxy those years, and obviously the Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 movie released, and I was really happy. Guardians of the Galaxy 2 was all about Star-Lord finding his father and obviously Ego, the living planet. A year later, they also introduced the Guardians of the Galaxy in Lego Marvel 2. In 2014, they also edited the Guardians of the Galaxy in the Lego Marvel game, but they weren't really the essential, I guess, characters. But in the second game, you could actually play with the characters that they have like a purpose in the game. You know, that's epic. By this time, you know, I was already a big Guardians of the Galaxy fan. I read those comics and stuff like that. And yeah, I really liked it. So that was nice. And I think, you know, a few years passed. And Guardians of the Galaxy, the video game came out. Absolutely loved that shit, man. Dude, Rikuro was in it. And so I guess the perfect game ever existence, you know. By this time, I believe Disney also, fired James Gunn, because he had some tweets flying around from way back ago, a few years ago, I don't know, and they fired him. But, you know, the greatest comeback stories always happen. And James Gunn was, you know, hired again for Guardians of the Galaxy 3. And oh my days. If this were to happen, you know, I would never have made this video. He also obviously made the Suicide Squad, because, you know, DC wants him to. And, you know, we all know how that happened, because the Suicide Squad is one of the best comic book movies I've ever seen. And then we go to Comic-Con last year, which was 2022, and we've got our first looks at the High Evolutionary for the Guardians of the Galaxy 3 movie. Oh my god, I was so fucking hyped. I shared so many photos of him because he looked so badass, so dope, so awesome. And obviously we also got the Guardians of the Galaxy Holiday Special, not to be confused with the best Star Wars special ever made. Oh yeah, and the Guardians also appeared in the Infinity War and Endgame, but yeah, you get the gist, you know. And Thor 4. I'm about to see Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3 in a few days. And, you know, I just can't wait to watch this movie. I've been waiting so damn long for this one. This is going to be the last one, and yeah, I'll cry, that's for sure, because I can't even, you know, keep my tears in my eyes when I watched that one clip with Rocket, Lila, Thief, and Floor. You know, it's not going to work, man, but dude, I'm going to be so fucking happy when I watch this movie. I've been dying to see this one, and I just want to say, oh, thanks, Guardians of the Galaxy, for, you know, making who I am, today. Because, you know, without I think Guardians of the Galaxy in my life would have been very dull, right? So I guess that's cool. This is a mix between Star Wars and Marvel, and if you haven't seen like any other Marvel movies before, Guardians of the Galaxy is the one you really need to watch, because, you know, it combines humor, sci-fi, adventure, heroes from different planets. It's so epic.